The status of heroes upon saints and martyrs. The physical power of those saints hardly reflects the astonishing Jesus Christ, in whom Michelangelo concentrated his knowledge of ancient art. The tight athletic body reveals enormous strength, unknown in other likenesses of Christ. At the same time, the face inspired by Apollo of the Belvedere emanates calmness and almost estrangement from the wild crowds around. Christ the Judge disturbs the viewer, while Mary is looking down with merciful compassion, leading the way to paradise. The fresco consists of human bodies only, each being different and each revealing the truth about their soul. The wealth of human experience is eternized on a wall by one amazing artist. Those who ignored the call to greatness are falling down on the other side of the wall to hell. They are getting smaller, darker, and more blurred as they're plunging into the infernal abyss. Some faces are terrified, others desperate. Inspired by this work, John Paul II wrote a poem in which he captured the passionate message of the fresco. In the Sistine, the artist painted the judgment. The judgment dominates the whole interior. Here, the invisible end becomes poignant visibly. The end is also the summit of transparency. Such is the path of all generations. In the new millennium, the Church continues its dialogue between art and faith. In 2009, Pope Benedict XVI chose the Sistine Chapel to meet with modern artists in a new attempt at cooperation between the Church and art.
Si tratta di una seducente ma ipocrita bellezza che ridesta la brama, la volontà di potere, di possesso, di sopraffazione sull'altro, e che si trasforma ben presto nel suo contrario, assumendo le volte dell'oscenità, della trasgressione e della provocazione fine a se stessa. L'autentica bellezza, invece, schiude il cuore umano alla nostalgia, al desiderio profondo di conoscere, di amare, di andare verso l'altro, verso l'oltre da sé. Se accettiamo che la bellezza ci tocchi intimamente, ci ferisca, ci apra gli occhi, allora riscopriamo la gioia della visione, della capacità di cogliere il senso profondo del nostro esistere, il mistero di cui siamo parte e da cui possiamo attingere la pienezza, la felicità, la passione dell'impegno quotidiano. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
And thus the Church has held a friendly hand to art. But how will it respond in our modern and ever-changing world? Those walls keep 2,000 years of history and art. The Vatican Museum intensify historical events and human achievements through the constant quest for transcendence. The greatness that surpasses the earthly shape of the human being makes them in the image and after the likeness of God, as was painted by Michelangelo in the Sistine Chapel. The message expressed in a number of forms and manners has appealed for centuries to thousands of visitors who fill up the rooms every day. In the Vatican Museum, they may admire beauty ever ancient, ever new, which gives the foretaste of eternity, to quote St. Augustine. And the thrilling truth is that even today, people look, listen, and understand.